Welcome to Suzanne Wagner's Intuitive Patterns for the month of September, 2013. Sometimes when I look at the cards, the intensity from the cards is somewhat gloomy. Such is the case this month. Honestly, I was a bit surprised, because astrologically, we are finally having a bit of an uptick from the Grand Water Trine. But with that much water in flow, it is easy to forget that this can also cause the deep stirring of emotions within each of us. One of the drawbacks of Neptune in Pisces is that people with addictions can become more addicted. People with depression can fall deeper into depression. So be warned that staying on top of your own emotional state is going to be your top priority this month. Remember that feelings are energy in motion. Just allow them to flow. Do not grab onto them. Realize that all emotion is transitory. Everyone has moments that cause them great consternation and stress. Those moments always happen, but it is what you do with the energy and the story that you tell yourself about that moment that can have lingering effect over your life. One of the things I love about astrology, tarot, and numerology is that they are a constant reminder that all things change. All things have cycles. We all have things we have decided to do and experience. Some of those things take time. Most things of great value take a lot of time. And things rarely go smoothly. Without a challenge here and there, life would be very dull and boring. But timing is everything. This month you might be asking yourself the question, am I in the right place? If not, the energy of change is definitely giving you a doorway into another plane of existence. Do you have enough self-esteem to take that moment as your moment in time? Are you going to let old disappointments, guilt, and sorrow define you for eternity? I hope not. You have within you the mystical power to transform the manifestations in your life into something that inspires others with your truth, vulnerability, and authenticity. Whether you admit it or not, you are on the most glorious journey. It is called your life, and it is better than fiction. It is deeper, messier, and has real things to conquer. What defines us in life is not our failures, but what we do with that failure. You should never let go of your dream. That dream might get delayed or postponed, but that vision should become the guiding force for your life. When you allow that to happen, magic can embody and enliven your world. You will try. And sometimes you will fail. But the greater failure is if you never try at all. You have earned this most precious moment to be alive. What are you going to do with it? When you are older, will you have all the money but no friends? When you are dying, will you still be holding back your love from someone who wants it desperately? Will you still be holding on to a belief or a situation that you refuse to allow to heal? Let September be the moment when you let it all go. Do not allow yourself to wallow in the addictive patterns of Neptune that will try to distract you from the infinite possibility that you are. But use Neptune to inspire your creative talents and give your mind unlimited potential to become the life force you came to be. Let your essential self release all the patterns that are not serving your highest self. So much energy is wasted in avoidance of the truth. So let the energy that could be used for something else, perhaps even that dream of yours, choose to let your emotions out of the way and allow yourself to become your highest, best, and true self. You will not be disappointed. You will be free. You will have the strength of a horse, and the spirit of magic will breathe you back into existence. I'll see you next month. Bye.